it seems possible that we will be using all of the training data available on the internet within this decade. Most of the progress we have seen in the past few years in AI has been the result of scaling, which means making models bigger, training them on more data, spending more computational resources on the training. A very important ingredient for this process is the training data, right? If you use all of the training data available on the internet or from whatever source that you are using, that means that you cannot scale efficiently or effectively anymore. This big source of improvements that we have seen so far would dramatically slow down. The rate of progress would also slow down significantly. There is a huge amount of data on the internet. A lot of people ask how we might be able to use all of it. And even though it might seem incredible, we actually are not that far off from that point. So the amount of data used by large language models for training has increased by a factor of 2 every year for the past few years. And we are now using tens of trillions of words in a training run. In comparison, the internet has somewhere in the vicinity of 100 trillion words, maybe up to 1,000 trillion words. It's only a relatively small factor above what we are already using, like a factor of 30 maybe, which, given the exponential increase in the data usage so far, would only take a few more years to reach. You might think, okay, but data is not doesn't disappear after you use it once. And the thing is, yes, you can use data more than once, but when you do that, the efficiency of training starts decreasing until you reach a point where it doesn't help at all to train on the same data for more times. We can look at the trend in how much data has been used for training runs over time. And in fact, that trend has been growing fairly reliably at about a factor of two per year. So we can simply project that trend forwards. And this tells us more or less what we expect the future to look like if conditions don't change much relative to the present. Furthermore, we can also know what recipes are being used to train these models, right? We know how models scale in terms of how much data is needed for a certain model size in order to make the optimal use of computational resources. And we believe these rules are unlikely to change in the near future. So given the expectations we have about how much compute is going to be available over the next few years, we can translate that into an amount of data that would be required to make optimal use of that compute. It seems possible that we will be using all of the training data available on the internet within this decade. Synthetic data, in theory, can generate unlimited data. So it might be used to overcome this potential data bottleneck. We have already seen a few cases of synthetic data significantly helping to improve AI performance, most notably in fields like game playing, mathematics, programming. The problem with synthetic data is that it is data generated by the model itself, right? So it's like if a student were teaching himself how to become better. It generally doesn't work that way. You need someone better than yourself to teach you. In certain domains, we are able to do this because we know objectively what a correct answer looks like or what a better answer looks like. In mathematics, there's a well-defined answer. So a model can try a bunch of different approaches, see which one works, and then train on the correct one and discard the unsuccessful ones. We, in more subjective domains like general reasoning or language, we don't know how to rank these solutions to a question or a problem. So the model is not by itself able to learn by its own output. And in fact, what tends to happen is this phenomenon that's been called model collapse, in which the model first makes some mistakes, and since it has no way of correcting those mistakes, it amplifies them over time. And you end up with a model that's eventually useless. You have this degeneration over time. If you use synthetic data in a naive way by directly training a model on its own outputs, It indeed does seem likely that model collapse will eventually happen, and you won't have sustained improvement in the performance of the model. Recent research have shown that it is possible to use certain approaches to make synthetic data useful. In particular, verification of the outputs of the model, some reinforcement learning approaches where the model learns how to improve its own answer, and other similar techniques and new ones that could be discovered might enable effective and scalable use of synthetic data. While generating data might seem very computationally intensive, could appear to be very inefficient as a method for continuing scaling of large language models, in practice, it's not such an important concern. So for example, when AlphaZero was being trained, this game playing model by DeepMind in 2016, they used 100 times more compute for data generation than for actually training the model. In practice, it's likely that scalable synthetic data generation pipelines would not even need that much overhead. So maybe we are looking at only twice as much compute as would be necessary for training a model without synthetic data, or maybe 10 times as much. As long as our computational resources are increasing exponentially, it doesn't really matter. You could also train on other modalities in addition to text. For example, images, video, or audio. There are a significant amount of images on the web and also seconds of video comparable to the total amount of text that you can find. It's not clear how to compare these sources of data, right? How much is an image worth in words? While we don't know the exact answer, we can try to approximate it using several techniques. On the one hand, we can look at how many tokens are used to encode images by the existing models compared to words. So usually, more or less, one token corresponds to one word, slightly less. Meanwhile, an image usually requires between 200 and 1,000 tokens to compress. So by this metric, you could say that maybe an image is worth as much as 200 words. But actually, it seems likely that a significant amount of the information encoded in this way is redundant. There's a lot of redundant information in images. Some models have tried to eliminate all of the redundancy and arrive at a much lower tokenization rate. So maybe 30 tokens per image. In that case, an image would only be worth as much as about 30 words. And similarly for a second of video. Even if we run out of data and we cannot train significantly larger models on larger amounts of data, we might not see a complete halt in progress in artificial intelligence. The techniques that are used to train these models, the architectures, the training code, the optimization, the way to represent the data, all of these improve over time. In fact, if we try to quantify how much of the improvement we have seen in the past few years comes from algorithmic improvements versus compute scaling, we see that they are not that different. So even if scaling came to a complete stop, it is possible that we would see AI progress at roughly half the speed that we were seeing before. When it comes to data, quantity is not the only thing that matters. Quality is also very important. This is immediately noticeable to anyone who has tried to train a model for tasks for which there is no related data whatsoever. If we want to understand data quality, there are a bunch of different dimensions that we can look into. On the one hand, data that is very redundant and that has very repetitions is less useful than data which is mostly free of repetitions. But that's not all. There's also how much mismatch there is between the data you are using to train and the task you actually want to perform. So for example, if you want your model to be able to write code, but you only train it on natural language, it will tend to perform much worse. Nobody, as of today, knows how to measure data quality in a very rigorous and reliable way. But we know that it is important because if we measure how much performance models get when trained on different datasets, they often differ by a very significant factor. There are several questions that we would have to answer to determine whether data bottlenecks are going to significantly limit AI progress in the future. How fast will algorithmic improvement be? Will scaling continue to yield big improvements? It's possible that we will reach a point where further scaling leads to a plateau in performance. Are there other bottlenecks that will bind before data? So for example, energy usage or hardware supply? The question of whether model collapse will prevent us from leveraging synthetic data at scale, or whether we will find a scalable way to teach models new information by themselves.